Hey there, what is up? Today I'm going to show you how to handle cases like this, in which you have some texts that are short and then some are long, like this one, yet all these three elements are equally sized. And the same thing with the buttons. As you can see, despite having texts with different lengths, the buttons have the exact same size. So this is the before. It looks really ugly and unprofessional. This version literally hurts designers on the inside. And after, that's what you're going to learn how to do in this video right now. Here we are, back to the before version, and really quickly, let me just give you a tour of the code right here. Basically, this whole thing is a column, and within that column, we have two main elements, which is this container right here and this column. This is the container, and this is the column. The column, as you can see, has three elevated buttons, so pretty straightforward. And then you have the container, and inside this container, the width is a static value, because that's not really important in this example. All containers have the same width. There's a little bit of padding to make it look nice. The color, the icon, the title, and the body. That's literally the same thing for the other ones, as you can see. They are all the exact same container. The only thing that changes is pretty much the icon, the title, and more importantly, the description text. So this is pretty straightforward. All you want is to not be able to see this grid right here that is essentially representing the row space around here. You want to have, let's call them cards. You want to have these cards filling up the whole space so that it looks nice. And I can even remove this color right now because it was just to show you the row area. And like this, obviously no app looks like this. This looks terrible. You obviously want all of these to have the exact same size. And one option you could do would be to just say cross-axis alignment on the row, and remember that this is the entire row. And here you just say cross-axis alignment dot stretch. And I'm going to hit save, but we're going to get an error here. It's going to disappear because this row is within a column and it has infinite amount of space and it's just a mess. So an easy way to do this would just be giving this container a height. Let's give it maybe 300. Let's see if that's enough. Hit the save button and there you go. And then, you know, you could make it smaller just to try to get the space right, etc. But, you know, this isn't the ideal solution, obviously. What you want to do is you want to wrap the row right here with an intrinsic height class. Now, if I hit save, what is going to happen is nothing, because you have to remove this height right here in order for the intrinsic height to take effect. So now we're finally going to get the desired outcome, like so. Now, the reason this isn't exactly like the after picture, let's call it that, is because we need to come here to each container, and each container has its own column, and within this column, you gotta give it the alignment, just to make sure you center the content. So you just gotta do this, and you hit save, and boom. I'm gonna do it to the other two now. Not that this last one is very important, but I did it anyway. I hit save, and as you can see, now everything is more centered, and it looks better. Honestly, it doesn't look too good, so maybe you can tell the copywriter to make this a little bit smaller, because this text is just making it ugly design-wise, but you know, as a programmer, this is as far as you go. And in this case, you can actually remove this and it will still look good, look the same. But usually it won't work unless you have this. But in this specific case, you would get away with it, like you can see right now. And now you can probably already guess what's going on with this right here. You really just gotta come over here and hit that Alt Enter and wrap a widget and call it intrinsic width. You want it to equal the child with the biggest width this time, while here you want the other children to equal the highest child, or the tallest child, whatever you want to call it. However, if I hit save like this, nothing happens. And, you know, that's because you need to have this cross-axis alignment. Now I'm gonna hit save, and boom, everything is equally sized, width and height-wise, and this is pretty simple. You know, it might seem like a really nice, cheap solution that you can just use all over your project. However, I must warn you not to do that, exactly because of this that says right here in the documentation. This class is relatively expensive because it adds a speculative layout pass before the final layout phase. Don't worry about the technical details too much. What matters is you should avoid using it where possible. Only use this very, very rarely, okay? If you can find other solutions, go ahead. But there are a lot of occasions where this will come in clutch for you. So you can just go ahead and use it. Just do not abuse it. Otherwise, your app's performance may just take a big hit. And your users are definitely not going to like that. So I'm gonna leave this code repo in the description so you can check it out if you want. But this is pretty straightforward stuff. Like it says right here, these kinds of widgets are essentially a widget that sizes its child to the child's intrinsic height. Meaning this widget's child is the row, and so this row's children are sized according to the tallest or the widest child, depending on the case. In this case, we sized all of them according to this one, which is the tallest one, and here we sized them all according to this one because it's the widest one. So that's pretty much it. If this video helped you, you already know, hit that like button, and to keep on learning Flutter, hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.